taken, but I'm technically free. But you want it so bad, so you just keep on telling lies. Do you not see my pain when you look into my eyes?
Hey everybody, welcome back to Morning Coffee with Rick Alexander. This week we're going to try something a little bit new. We're going to put a theme through the week. And so all of the Morning Coffee episodes, however many there are, will fall within the theme of this week, and they'll all kind of tell a consistent series, so it'll be, you know, part one through three or four. And that's what we're going to try to do. So this week's theme, it's not as philosophical as I normally get, but I do think that it's really important information to know. So what we're going to call this week's theme is, this is how you take care of yourself. See, because we live in a world where a lot of times we know the right things to do, and we're very quick to do things for others, but we don't always step up for ourselves. We don't always do our due diligence to make sure that we're catering to ourselves and to our own needs. We don't necessarily always prioritize ourselves. And the problem with not prioritizing yourself and with sort of giving all of yourself to the world and not having anything left over for you is that you actually don't show up in the world in the most productive way possible. And that is the issue when you don't prioritize yourself. So even if you are somebody who is used to self-sacrifice, which is a lot of us, right? We feel like we have to sacrifice ourselves in order for, you know, responsibilities for families, for friends, for relationships, for social reasons and obligations. Like, there's a lot of reasons. But even if you think about yourself as from a position of servitude, if you cater to yourself and to your own needs, then you actually show up more fit for service. And that, I think, is the essence of why self-care is so important. So today, number one on this is how you take care of yourself is structure, routine, and habit. See, I am somebody that is a pretty free spirit. I like to experiment with different things. I like to try different things. I like to not feel shackled down all of the time. But here is one thing that I've had to confront in all of my freedom. The human mind absolutely, undeniably needs routine. And so if you don't have any routine to your life, if you don't have any structure to your life, the human mind doesn't feel like it has something to grab onto. You know, I always talk about coherence. Well, the cornerstone of coherence in the human psyche is having structure and routine. Now, you could be somebody like right now, I'm living on the road. I'm doing this episode from Virginia. I did the last episode from Florida, and the next episode is going to be from Las Vegas. And then I'm recording from Zion next week. And so trust me when I say, like, finding routine within all of the madness of my like gypsy lifestyle as it is right now can be really difficult. But what I've done and what I would encourage you to do is to come up with ways every single day that you can just build something into your day so that your mind has routine. So something to ground yourself with, something to center yourself with. So a lot of the routines that I now have, like I ensure that regardless of the time zone I'm in, I get up at 6. Like that's been something I've really strived to do. And when I don't do it, I feel the effects of it. Even if I get more sleep. One thing that's really difficult, like I said, is the human mind needs routine. And so if I don't stick to that routine, I really do feel the effects of it. I don't feel as productive. I don't feel like I'm getting things done. And that's another thing that routine and structure gives us. So even if you live somewhere where you're like working a 9-to-5 job and you are just kind of going, you have a very routined life, it's important to build in routines and structures for you. Because a lot of times I think we have responsibilities to the kids and to family members. And so we're kind of like running around and yeah, we're going to work and then we run to the gym and then we got to sprint from the gym to pick up the kids. And we got to go to practice and we got to go to over here to pick up whoever. And it's like, okay, that might be routine. That might be monotonous. But what in your schedule is for you? What is giving back to you? What's allowing you to step into the person that you should be? So for me, the one thing I always do is I journal, stream of consciousness style. So it doesn't matter if I'm on the road, it doesn't matter if I'm at home, it doesn't matter if I'm in my local coffee shop or It truly does not matter. I always ensure that I have like stream of consciousness writing in the morning. And then I have a couple breathing techniques that I do as well, because no matter what, I realize no matter where I am, not only can nobody take those from me, but they center me. They ground me. They allow me to like make sense of the world, and they allow me to try to bring my body to be more parasympathetic, honestly, to be more in recovery mode and not so reactive to everything. And I try to do that as best I can before I check social media and my email and all these other kind of crazy things that I know are just going to be vying for my attention. So part one, this is how you take care of yourself. You find, and it can be so simple, structures, habits, routine, something for yourself. Another thing that I do, and I realize not everybody can do this, I really do understand this, but I've been building in time in my schedule. I literally have been putting it in my calendar to stop and think. That's no phone, no inputs, no nothing. Because what I find is, you know, our entire days are spent in reactive mode. And so we never get time to sort of just think like, what do I actually want? What do I actually think about all of the things that I'm doing? What do I think about the situations that I'm in right now? What do I think about the amount of money I'm making or the jobs that I'm doing or, you know, this thing that I'm getting ready to commit to? Like whatever it is, a lot of times since we're in reactive mode all day, as decisions come in, we're just reacting and then we're deflecting and we're just sort of trying to get by. And because we never prioritize ourselves first, we always feel like we're trying to catch up. We always feel like we're an inch below the surface of the water and we cannot get a breath. And so what I would encourage you today is to find something to make yours, to make just for you, non-negotiable. And you know, I suggest that you figure out a way to do that so that it doesn't matter where you are or what the circumstances or what the situation is. Something to ground you, something to center you, something to sort of give you energy to serve you so that as you go meet the needs of the day, you are more inclined and ready to do that. So part one, this is how you take care of yourself. Build yourself a structure. I'll talk to you tomorrow on Morning Coffee.